So I purchased the base model of M1 MacBook Air, and after using it for a couple of weeks, here are three things that I love about this laptop and three things that I absolutely hate. Let's start with the gorgeous 2560x1600 resolution screen, which is way higher than typical 1080p panels that you will find on comparatively priced Windows laptops. It's also really bright, clocking 400 nits of brightness, and offers wide viewing angles and 114% sRGB color gamut. These are insane numbers for any laptop, not just M1 MacBook Air in this price range. So Apple has really put a very high quality panel on this laptop. Let's talk about the build quality. So I find MacBook Air's all aluminium build quality just amazing. There is no creaking, flexing, or bending, and the fit and finish is impeccable. It almost feels like a unibody design with no visible gaps or seams. You have a choice of going with traditional colors like the space gray or silver, but I decided to go with the gold color, which looks really stunning in my opinion. Now, I appreciate the fact that Apple does not litter their laptop with these ugly stickers that you find on Windows laptops. You also will not find any vent on the bottom of MacBook Air because it's a fanless design. Let's talk about the keyboard. So ever since Johnny Ives introduced that dumbass butterfly keyboard, MacBook users, they have been plagued with horrible typing experience. But not anymore, guys, because M1 MacBook Air is using the traditional scissor switch keyboard, and I love typing on this laptop. It provides nice balanced keys that offer just the right amount of key travel and a perfect actuation force that results in great tactile feedback. When it comes to typing experience, I will put MacBook Air right up there with ThinkPad Carbon X1, which in my opinion has the best keyboard in any laptop. Now let's talk about the trackpad. So M1 MacBook Air offers a large glass trackpad, which is a joy to use thanks to the smooth surface and a large, you know, area. Interestingly, this trackpad doesn't physically move or click, but it simulates clicking using some voodoo magic that Apple calls Force Touch. I also appreciate the fact that this laptop comes with fingerprint sensor that doubles as a power button. While the screen on M1 MacBook Air is great, I hate its chunky bezels and the lack of touchscreen display. Being used to touchscreen display on both my Windows laptop and Chromebooks, it's very jarring to suddenly use a laptop which does not have touchscreen display functionality. It feels weird and archaic in 2021. Honestly, I don't understand why Apple is resisting, putting a touchscreen display on their new laptops, especially now when the M1 MacBook Air natively supports many iOS apps that are designed for touch. Personally, after using Yoga 7i and Flex 5 touchscreen laptops that support active stylus pen, I am convinced that all thin and light laptops need to have the touchscreen functionality. For the price, M1 MacBook Air is a ridiculously fast machine. In fact, this is the fastest thin and light laptop that I have ever used. And mind you guys, I am using the base model of M1 MacBook Air that only comes with a puny 8GB system RAM and 256GB SSD. In spite of these low specifications, I can run almost over a dozen apps and smoothly toggle, between these apps without any lag. Resource-hungry apps like DaVinci Resolve, which I use for video editing, it runs butter smooth on M1 MacBook Air, despite, just having 8GB RAM. Now, a typical thin and light laptop from Windows world, if it had only 8GB RAM, it will not, be able to run apps like DaVinci Resolve smoothly. In fact, you will most likely need a fat gaming laptop with tons of system RAM and a discrete NVIDIA GPU to run something like DaVinci Resolve. So here's a million-dollar question. Why is MacBook Air able to deliver this kind of crazy performance despite having low system RAM and, it doesn't even have a discrete GPU? So the first and the obvious reason is that the M1 silicon is awesome. It's the fastest chip in the market in this low thermal envelope category, and it puts both Intel and AMD to shame. Now, enough has already been said about this chip, so I will move on to the next reason, which is the on-die unified memory architecture. So this architecture allows system RAM to sit very close to the GPU and the CPU cores. As a result, both graphics and compute cores can fetch opcodes and data packets very quickly, resulting in a blazing, system performance. I think both Intel and AMD should consider using this unified memory architecture in their future chip designs, at least, the thin and light laptop chip designs. Intel should definitely put the memory on the die. So guys, here is the bottom line. Apple's M1 chip is a total beast, and there is nothing in the Windows world as of now that can compete with it. Added bonus is that this laptop comes with a blazing fast SSD, which keeps up with the M1 silicon's, really fast performance. And so the end result is that you get a kick-ass overall performance from this laptop. In my opinion, guys, Apple has learned all the wrong lessons from the success of iPad. I hate the iPadification of, the new M1 MacBook Airs. Apple has gone full proprietary mode with this laptop, and there is literally nothing that you can upgrade once you buy the M1 MacBook Air. This is a very tightly locked and sealed device with zero upgrade options down the road. So that means you are stuck with the 256 gig SSD storage and the 8 gig system RAM if you buy the base model. Now you have the option of picking more RAM and SSD while you are purchasing the laptop, but Apple will charge you an arm and a leg for these upgrades. But the good news is that the base model with 8 gig system RAM is plenty for most folks. Like I mentioned before, the base model of M1 MacBook Air, it performs like a champ and it chews through any task that I throw at it. But here is the problem, guys. Who knows how the Mac OS or various applications that I'm using today, how will they behave in the future? Software tends to get bulky and resource hungry over time. And if you intend to keep this laptop for a long time, the lack of upgrade options may be the Achilles heel for this laptop. The third thing that I love about MacBook Air is its fanless design and stellar battery life. Apple claims 18 hours of battery life during typical video playback and 15 hours during internet surfing with the Wi-Fi turned on. Now, unlike other laptop makers who proclaim long battery life but fail to deliver on their promise, Apple is shockingly accurate with, the claim that they are making for the battery life, assuming you are using the Safari browser. But what I found is that if I use my browser of choice, which is Mozilla Firefox or Google Chrome, then the battery life takes a hit, and I have seen anywhere from 60 to 90 minutes of battery deficit if I use these browsers. Regardless, M1 MacBook Air has broken my nightly ritual of charging all my devices before I go to bed. Since its battery life is so good, I don't feel the need to charge it frequently, unlike all my other Windows laptops. I also love the M1 MacBook Air's fanless design. It's whisper quiet even while running demanding tasks like video editing and photo editing. This almost feels magical, guys, because intuitively I expect the fans in my laptop to kick in and make a lot of noise when I'm doing something CPU intensive. But the M1 MacBook Air keeps chugging along nicely, and all I hear is a pin drop silence. Mac OS looks pretty, no doubt about that. But boy, do I miss Windows 10. There are some basic features that I took for granted on Windows 10, and I sorely miss these features on the Mac OS. For example, when I'm downloading or copying a file, I can see its progress right in the taskbar, since Windows Explorer icon is dynamic and it shows the progress in real time. Similarly, while rendering a video, I can see the progress by just looking at the application icon on the taskbar. This functionality is missing in macOS, and as a long-time Windows user, I find this omission very surprising. Also, Windows 10 allows you to automatically snap windows by dragging them to the corners. You can't do that on Mac. I'm sure there are third-party apps that will replicate this feature, but the Mac OS natively doesn't support this feature. Now, in Windows 10, you can use something called Microsoft Power Toys, which makes it very easy to create complex Windows layout and quickly position windows in these layouts. So, for example, in my desktop, I have these three predefined regions, and I can drop any application in those regions, and it automatically snaps in. So guys, long story short, while I love the M1 MacBook Air's hardware, I miss the features from Windows 10 operating system. Now, in the past, Apple allowed dual booting via Boot Camp, so that meant that you could have both Windows and Mac OS on the same laptop, but unfortunately, M1 MacBook Air doesn't support this feature, and it really sucks. So these are the three things that I love about this laptop and the three things that I hate about this laptop. So it's just 2 weeks since I've been using this laptop, and I intend to do a full review of this laptop on this channel. So if you guys are not subscribed to TechnoPanda, please consider doing so. So that's it for today, guys. If you found this video useful, please smash the like button. It encourages the YouTube algorithm to recommend this video and help this channel grow. Also check out TechnoPandaReviews.com, where I have consolidated all the laptop reviews that I have done over the years on this channel. So again, guys, thanks for watching this video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.